And when I squeeze the calf, the foot flexes. That's normal. On this side, when we bring the patient's foot up, it's pointing directly to the wall. And when I squeeze the calf, nothing happens there. So that is a complete Achilles tendon rupture. So that's the diagnosis. Now let's get it fixed.
So my name is Chase Korn. I've been with TO for 6 years, and I'm an orthopedic foot and ankle specialist. So the Achilles tendon is the primary plantar flexor of the foot. It attaches the calf muscle to the back of the heel, or the calcaneus. That's what you use to push off when you take a step. That's plantar flexion. So the most common injuries are either inflammatory, like a tendonitis or inflammation of the tendon, or then obviously traumatic injuries, so partial or complete tears or ruptures. So the injury is usually based on the mechanism. We see them a lot when athletes plant and redirect. So it's loading that tendon as you're pushing off usually causes the injury. And most people and young, healthy athletes will elect to repair these Achilles tendons to just expedite the healing, get them back faster. And so once we've had that conversation, surgery can be done quickly, and recovery is usually typically about 3 to 4 months before we have you back to sports. Achilles tendons can happen in best case scenario. You know, just playing sports, they can happen. But in general, maintaining flexibility and strength is going to prevent injury. So making sure you stretch before you participate in sports, you don't go out there cold, and then making sure you just stay relatively fit with, you know, I really like yoga. I think it's a great example we see as preventative to joint and tendon injuries. Achilles tendon rupture will be very obvious. Most patients describe they planted redirect and they either felt a pop or thought that someone kicked them in the back of the ankle, but it can be less severe. Say you have Achilles tendonitis. Any pain, swelling, or inflammation is sort of a sign of a problem there. Non-operative treatment of an Achilles tear is first a period of immobilization, so just to allow the healing to occur. After an appropriate period of immobilization, then obviously there's physical therapy involved to re-strengthen the tendon and get the mobility back in the ankle joint. You know, most orthopedic surgeons are pretty good at diagnosing an Achilles tendon rupture without having to get advanced imaging and MRI scans and that sort of thing. 80% of the time, I pretty much know that diagnosis in the office with just a good history, obtaining, you know, information about the mechanism of the injury and then a simple examination of the patient. Physical therapy is an integral part of healing and recovery, whether you treat this with surgery or without surgery. And the duration really depends on the preference of the doctor and the patient and how they are coming along in the recovery process. That can go anywhere from 4 to 8 weeks after recovery. You know, one of the things that I think has really come along that's changed the way that we manage Achilles tendon injuries is being able to address them surgically through a minimally invasive approach. So for a traditional Achilles tendon repair, the incision may have been, you know, 10, 12 centimeters. Now we're talking about an incision that's, you know, 2.5 centimeters wide, and we can repair the tendon through that incision. Fortunately for me, learning it early on in my career, that's all I've done in my practice here. So I'm exclusively using that technique for all my Achilles tendon repairs at this point.